My name is Paul Sokoloff. I'm a botanist and I work for the Canadian Museum of Nature in Ottawa. We're here in Resolute, where my colleague Dr. Troy McMullen and I have been collecting lichens and vascular plants of the high Arctic. We're actually bouncing around quite a bit between different communities. We started here in Resolute, and tomorrow we're going to head to Eureka, which is on the Fosheim Peninsula of Ellesmere Island. From there, we'll pop over to Expedition Fjord, which is on Axel Heiberg Island, and then we'll end up at Lake Hazen, which is a northern research camp on the side of this massive freshwater lake in Kirtinerpak National Park. So while I'm up here, I'm collecting all of the vascular plants at each of the stops that we're going to. A vascular plant is a plant that you or I would think of as a plant. It's got roots, shoots, flowers. If you went out and pointed at a tree, that's what a vascular plant is. Of course, there are no trees in the Arctic because we're far above the tree line. So what I'm doing is I'm collecting these plants, documenting where I collected them, what the environment was like, taking a lot of photos, and then I'll press them in a plant press, which is just like sheets of cardboard bound together with straps. And once they're dry and two-dimensional, they'll last for hundreds of years. Each time somebody collects a plant or any kind of organism and documents where it was collected, when it was collected, who it was collected, that specimen becomes a data point that says that this species was found growing at this place at that time. We'll take all of the plants that we're collecting on this expedition and file them in the National Herbarium of Canada. That's essentially a giant plant library that's housed at the Canadian Museum of Nature. All of those specimens together form this baseline data for where plants are in the Arctic. This is especially important because as the Arctic is changing, we'll be using collections and the data that comes from them to really see how is the Arctic changing and how has it changed through time. Now, we are here in the herbarium where we store our pressed and dried plant collection. This particular sheet here, this is called Brea humilis subspecies Elsmerensis. And Elsmerensis is essentially the Latin way of saying that it is only found or originally found on Ellesmere Island in Nunavut. This particular subspecies can only really be found on the northern tip of that island. So when we got off the plane at Lake Hazen and we saw it growing on the sand around the camp, we were super excited, or at least I was really excited. So this is that particular specimen. We dug it out, we pressed it, we flattened the plant, and it is stored in these cabinets with all of our other specimens. This other specimen here, this is a grass species, and this one is called Festuca Edlundier. And it is actually named after Dr. Sylvia Edlund, who was one of the first women to run a high Arctic research camp on Ellesmere Island in the Geological Survey. From this particular case, this was actually found by us at Eureka, the weather station on the tip of the Fosheim Peninsula, where her camp was located. And it was really interesting for us to find it because that's a bit of a range extension. It actually hadn't been found before at this weather station that she had traveled to so many years in the past. So to me, these are some of the coolest specimens from that trip. These sheets are just a small sample of what we collected on this particular expedition and a much smaller sample of what we hold here in the herbarium. If you'd like to see some of these specimens for yourself, check out the link in this video, which links to the Global Biodiversity Information Facility, where you can see all of our specimens and a whole lot more.